Hello everyone, welcome to today's Daily Dose TV. Going to be covering Days of Our Lives for the week of Monday, August the 7th to today, the 11th, August the 11th. What's going on in Salem? Weddings and babies. I swear, man, everybody's got the wedding baby fever. It is just everywhere you turn, somebody's having a baby. Somebody's getting engaged, and that is exactly what happened. Monday is the day of three proposals. Woohoo! Monday was the day of three proposals. That's all they did all day long. Everybody got proposed to. Who got proposed to? Well, we have someone standing in for our regular Eric, and he's pretty easy on the eyes. Anyway, fake Eric proposes to Sloan properly with a ring. Xander proposes to Chloe. Keep in mind that Xander still does not know he's a baby daddy. EJ proposes to Nicole again. Oh yeah, it's true. And those are our three proposals. So, what was our gals' answers? Did they say yes? Did they say no? Did they say scram? Well, here's the way we went down. Sloane accepted. Nicole accepted EJ's proposal. Chloe, however, did not accept, but she didn't turn him down. She said she needed a little bit of time, you know, to think it over. Don't do it, girl. Because, you know, she don't know there's a baby in the mix. But he expressed to her this week how he wants to get married. He wants to have children. And she's like, I never knew you wanted to have kids. Yeah, he wants to have children. But I thought there was some reason Chloe couldn't have kids. I know there was reasons for Nicole, but this is for Chloe. Okay. Gwen visits Leo to tell him goodbye as she's jetting off to Iceland with her hunky-dory new husband, Dimitri von Glossklinger. I know I said his name wrong. Shoot me. Don't really. Anyway, she goes, she wants to give her bestie a hug goodbye. That's what she says. And she is happier than I have ever seen her character. And you're sitting there, I'm sitting there thinking, well, maybe this will work out for her. But we know that 'tis not the way it's going to go. So Dimitri sneaks over to have a little visit downtown with Leo before he leaves. And this is when Leo finds out, you know, Leo's like, oh, I'm going to miss you so much while you're on your honeymoon. And Leo said, Dimitri said, would you just check your email? So just like you're thinking by now, if you don't already know, Dimitri got Leo a room in Iceland, paid for his airfare, paid for everything. They're in the same hotel, I believe he said, but they're far away from each other. So he plans while he's honeymooning to be able to sneak off and go downtown a time or two with Leo. Anyway, Gwenny finally gets in and she's like, what's wrong? What's the matter with you? You have someone in here. There's someone in the shower, isn't it? All right, come on out, Mr. Perry. Matthew, not the actor, Perry, from, you know, we all know what the MP stands for, and it's not Matthew Perry. So she knows somebody's in the bathroom. She's caught him. She's wanting him to come out. You know, Leo is freaking out. And so he finally says, you know, he's not going to come out, Gwenny, because... Shit. Because he's married. And that's what she told him. Alright, so everybody's getting engaged and everybody's having babies. Maggie decides to go do a pop-in surprise visit to Sarah. And of course she finds out she's pregnant. Sarah tries to tell her it's Rex's baby, but Maggie just knows that it's not. She figures it out. She agrees she would try to keep her secret, but she doesn't like it, and she doesn't want to do it. All right, so we move on to Tuesday. Abe, of course, has moved out, and he's living with Patch and Kayla. Enjoying himself, it looks like. He's sitting on the couch, just getting whatever he wants to eat, watching whatever he wants on TV. He's chilling like a villain. Okay, so now what do we have? We have the killer, the murdering, the mastermind, Ava Vitale, is back on the scene. She runs into Harris in the sanitarium. She thinks he's Charlie, you know, the dead boy from the crypt. And she tries to attack him and stuff like that. After she gets a couple of doses of medicine in her, she comes back and apologizes to him and explains to him about her life. And they seem to be bonding, you know, so I don't know. Sean's time up is being suspended. He goes back to the station. He doesn't know who he's supposed to meet or whatever, but he meets the new acting mayor or whatever, and he tells him he's reinstated and now he's going to take Rafe's spot and be the commish. The commish. The commissioner. And Sean tries to get out of it. Doesn't think he deserves it and stuff, and he's like, well, nonsense. Is this ever going to happen again? You know, you drinking on the job? He's like, no, sir. He's like, okay, you know, we'll be glad to have you. Too. Both your parents have been commissioners. You know, glad to have another Brady at the helm. I don't know what this guy has against the rapester, but definitely something. Okay, so, Belle has a hard time believing that, and she doesn't think that he should have took the position, but, you know, he was going to give it to somebody, so what the hey. So we move on to Wednesday, and we see that Ava and Harris, they're going to spend more time on them today, Wednesday, as they talk and get to know each other and confide in each other a little bit. Trip and Wendy end up getting them another room that's not registered to Leo. And they go to have them a night downtown. But right after they're getting ready to go downtown, Trip gets a call from the hospital that his mother is lucid and she wants to see him either now or between the hours, blah, 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 tomorrow. So Wendy tells him to go on and see her now and she'll just wait for him. Harris convinced her that she should go on and see her son because she said she just didn't want to make his life any worse on him. So she was trying to stay away from him. You know, Harris told her that's probably not, you know, good idea. That's not the best thing to do. Chanel, this mayor has got it in for Chanel and Paulina for some reason. I don't know why. And he goes and shuts Chanel down again because she doesn't have some little sticker that the city is supposed to give her that she applied for, but they never gave it to her. You know, she's all down and out, and Paulina's got her butt in a knot with her little tennis shoes. So, she says she's gonna have to take care of this. You know, Chanel tells her don't worry about it. Chanel sets down being real, you know, down and out. And, Johnny comes over and talks to her. Wait a minute. Not sure he talked to her first. Johnny comes over and talks to her. And then Talia comes up and wants to talk to her. They both end up telling her, I can't remember who told her first, that they have feelings for her. They both also ended up telling Marlena they had feelings for her, because Marlena's treating Talia, and Johnny just walked in and asked Marlena if he could talk to her. She is his grandma. So Marlena's got the info that they're both interested in Chanel, and now Chanel's got the info. Talia just kind of drops it and runs, you know. She says, well, I've got feelings for you, and if there's any way you can have feelings for me, you know, just let me know. And then she just takes off. And Chanel's just sitting there. And when Johnny was talking to her about his breakup with Wendy, she said, did she tell you why she picked Tripp over you? And he said, yeah. She said, I'm not over Chanel yet. I'm not over you yet. You know, and then he told her, it's the truth. I still have feelings for you. So now she knows that. We see Paulina's legs again, and she's sporting them little tennis shoes. I would imagine that all of them could wear tennis shoes, because they're not all the time filmed with their feet in their scenes. We move on to Thursday. I already told you, Belle thinks that Sean should turn down the commish job, but she is going to, you know, keep it. That's what he decided. Anyway. Let me see if I wrote this down here anywhere else. No. Okay. So what Paulina does is she ends up going over to talk to Abe. And Kayla's like, you're not supposed to come over here and see him. And Abe's like, I know you're my wife, but you've got to respect. I need some space. And she said, I know you can't be a husband, but can you be a mayor? And she told him, Chanel needs help. And you're the mayor. Are you with it enough where you can get this dropped off our bakery? And he's lucid and everything. He just doesn't remember everyone and everything. He don't remember shit. What am I talking about? But he's getting a much needed vacation. Just resting over there in his spiffy little sweater. Anyway, he says he'll do it. So he's gonna do something to get that dropped off Chanel's bakery so her bakery can get back in the business. Okay, so I gotta talk about all that. Thursday's pretty action-packed, and that's where we are. We've got another proposal coming up tomorrow, Friday, which was today, and I'll tell you about it in a minute. So Brady and, Kristen had to go to custody court, and Brady lost custody. Okay, so he's packing up Rachel's stuff, because he has to have Rachel delivered to Kristen by a certain time. Meanwhile, Kristen's got new bunk beds, and she's so excited to be able to have Rachel come live with her. And Chad's kids, Thomas and Charlotte, are coming over to have a sleepover, you know, and make her feel welcome there in her new home. So everybody's all excited about that. But Brady is back packing up her room, and him and John are talking about this doll they had to drive back from Timbuktu to get of Rachel's one time. And John has all kinds of surveillance on the house that they live in, or condominium, whatever it is. and on the internet and everything, and he's alerted anytime anything sketchy's going on. Well, Brady apparently went online and bought some kind of car that he's having delivered, not even to where he lives, but to somewhere else. So John said, so you're taking her over to Kristen's? He said, yeah, and I hate it. I hate it. I'd rather do anything. He said, would you rather buy a car off the internet in the middle of the night and have it delivered somewhere else so you can take Rachel off and y'all can be on the run for the rest of your life? And he's like, all right, you got me. So Brady is dead set on taking Rachel and going, because he's telling John, Kristen's going to turn, you know, Rachel against me. And this is not going to be good. So, you know, John begs him not to do it, but he takes off and gives John the impression he's going. He said, Dad, I love you. He said, I just can't let go of Rachel, and she's going to be turned against me, and my life won't be the same. And he said, but if you're on the run, you're going to have to be on the run for you and your little girl for the rest of your life. She's going to grow up and hate you for taking her away from her family, from her mother, from her home. You know, and Brady, he's out of his head, you know. So he takes off. And we don't know what's going to happen there. Stephanie gets a job offer working actually with Alex and that little cutoff dude. He's a sawed-off little fellow. Whatever his name is that he's in business with, and he tried to be in business with Maggie. I forget his name. But he recommends Stephanie as a PR person for a new project. Alex didn't know it was going to be Stephanie, because Chad and Alex had words earlier this week, just a few days ago, and he told Alex, you need to stay away from Stephanie, stay away from us, quit showing up to use our shower, quit showing up shirtless, just leave us alone, man. And he's like, so we don't all want to try to be friends? And Chad said, no. So he did this behind Stephanie's back, which of course she will find out about. So Chad and Alex had what they call a gentleman's agreement. They weren't going to say anything to Stephanie about that, and Alex said he was going to back off. So that's what's happening there. When Rachel goes to meet the guy about the job, and Alex sees that Stephanie has a fit, and he's busy trying to tell her that he can't work with her, and she demands he tell her why, and of course he told her, because Chad told me to stay away from him. Of course, she's super pissed at Chad and goes and has words with him. He thinks she's going to break up with him, but she doesn't. And she reassures him and stuff, but, you know, she tells him, we're already in Friday. She tells him, you know, that this happened today. She told him that, you know, he didn't have any right telling who she could be friends with, who she could work with, or any of that. So he says he's good with that, but he's all, I don't want to lose Stephanie. Well, you know, Alex just, he really is an aggressive suitor, so it was almost pissing me off at Stephanie that she was yelling at Chad, but I'll let her slide this one time. Not really, I'm not good with numbers. Okay, so I don't know where I'm going to get a picture at, but Bonnie is, she is dressed in some black sparkly dress that has got fringe hanging off of it. She has got an Elvis Presley looking dress on. It's sparkly, it's black, it normally would be pretty, but it's just not. It's hideous. And we had some other, you know, interesting wardrobes. I'm just going to do a whole video about that here in a few minutes. So, they have that black fringe on it. Xander runs into Brady in the square, and Brady's already spiraling out of control because, well, Kristen was getting freaked out, and she told EJ he's already late, so she called up Belle, and she's like, if your brother thinks I'm going to let him get away with, and she turned around, and Rachel's there. So Brady did do the right thing and deliver Rachel to Kristen. So Brady's grieving that and sitting in the square, and Xander rolls up and tells him, you know, I bet you're beside yourself, huh, mate? Yeah, me and Chloe are going to get married. I proposed to Chloe. And he's like, what? You know, he's just, Brady's having a bad, bad day, man. So if you ever were going to get driven to drinking, today would be the day you'd need to hitch that ride. So, they have a little back and forth conversation. Belle sees Chloe outside the pub, sits down and talks to her and asks her what's up. And she was busy telling her about Xander proposed to her. And Belle spends most of the episode trying to talk her out of it. You know, Chloe told Belle, you have no right to say nothing to me. What about when you were over there, you ran off with EJ? You know, I didn't say names, call you names or anything like that then. And she's like, yeah, you're right. So, everybody, they're waiting for Victor to come home. They're having a family gathering. Brady says he's not up for it, you know. He knows Xander will be there. He don't want to hear. I think Rex and Sarah are coming home. I don't know if they're coming home or if they end up just showing up. But Justin and Bonnie, or what name is she going by? Adrian? I think it's Bonnie. Justin and Bonnie and Maggie. They're all so excited waiting for Victor to come home. And then Justin comes in the room with the bad news that Victor's plane is missing. So we now know that this is finally, and it adds up to about 6 months since he died, John Aniston, may he rest in peace. So it's been about 6 months, so they're going to have him either disappeared forever, so they have that option to bring a character back, but I hope they don't. I think they should respect his character. He's done it for so many years, and let it rest. And of course, Maggie's all bent out of shape, and you know, everybody's, so this will be what I'm hearing, what will bring Philip back, and we'll see who all comes back. So that's a wrap for this week, the 7th through 11th. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and I will see you in Salem.